Best Bites on BCTV is supported by Comfort Pro Incorporated.
Hi, how you doing? This is Brad Weisman from Best Bites on BCTV. Once again, Mickey's traveling around the country, so he's not here today to try out some of the food. But we're at Gino's Grille. We're in the lobby right now, right next to the Christmas tree, because it's that time of year. But we're going to be trying all kinds of food. We got an appetizer we're going to be trying and two entrees. And I'm super excited because we actually ate at Gino's Cafe a couple months ago, and it was just fantastic. So come back to the kitchen and let's start cooking. So we're back now in the kitchen at Gino's Grille. Not Gino's Cafe, not the Blue Marsh Canteen. This is Gino's Grille.
Yep.
We got a chef here. You're the executive chef here?
Yes.
And your name is Zach.
Yeah.
How you doing, Zach?
Good. How about yourself?
I'm doing great. I'm really excited for some good food here. I've been here once, but didn't have a whole lot. I was here with my family. So I'm really looking forward to having something a little different. Because we were kind of in a hurry. When you have little kids, you got to be in a hurry to get out of here. So, yep. But what are you going to be making for us today?
Today I'm going to be making you a angel hair aglio.
Okay.
And that's pretty much just a traditional oil pasta.
Okay.
I'm going to be showing you one of my signature items, which is pork shank. Gets pan seared and then confit in pork fat for 24 hours and then deep fried to order.
Sounds basically very low fat.
Oh, it's very, very good for
but
the
But it's
heart.
Really good?
Yeah,
really
it falls
good?
Off the bone the second it's coming out the oven.
And this is your signature dish here at the restaurant?
Yep.
That's awesome.
Dish that I made.
And that's and all these things that we're trying to add, they're all on the menu?
Yes.
Excellent. That's great. So let's get started. Let's try this pasta. If you want to get things moving, we'll do it. Wow. I think you have enough pans there.
I fly through them. I do everything on the pans. All the vegetables,
everything.
All the pastas, all the sides, they all come off of over here because I do everything fresh.
Awesome. Now you're fairly young, Zach.
Yeah, so I'm only 26.
26 years old, and you said you started what, when you were 16?
Yeah. Started cooking whenever I was 16. I was only a busboy at 16, and I actually got to be able to cook at 18, and then I've been doing it ever since.
Unbelievable. Now what do we got going in there?
Right now it's a mix of vegetable oil and olive oil.
Okay.
I always do that for all my saute dishes because
you do a mix?
Yeah, if you do all olive oil it's gonna burn. So this way I'm able to get the pan hot and get the pine nuts and the garlic all browned off.
Unbelievable. You know, it's funny, I don't think, I've been doing this for a while, Mickey and I have been doing this for a while, and I don't think I've ever heard anybody do the combination before.
Yeah.
And that's because the olive oil burns. Mm-hmm. It does. It actually
does. Olive oil gets too hot. And for this dish, I like to completely toast everything off in there.
Right.
So by the time you get the pine nuts and the garlic all roasted and brown, they get most of their flavor coming off of them.
Now, what kind of a flavor? The pine nut gives it just a nutty flavor, right?
Yeah.
Is that really what it does?
Buttery and oily.
You know what's funny about pine nuts? They're not cheap.
Nope. It's the most expensive thing I have per pound in-house.
It is, right? They're really expensive. Because my wife will have me go and get pine nuts every once in a while at the grocery store. And when I get them, I always look at the price for what you get. I'm like, geez, these things are not cheap.
A little jar is like $9 or $10.
Yeah, exactly. So we're just going to kind of sear that up a little bit. Then what else is going to go in this dish?
After this, it's going to get spinach and tomatoes. And you'll see whenever these guys start to brown, I'm going to take it right off the heat and push it way back with the spinach because it starts to pop. And if you keep it on the heat, or even like keep it on the part where it was hot, it'll keep on burning.
So, okay, got it. So you don't want to go too far with those.
Nope.
So now we're going to add some tomatoes, a little bit of spinach.
A lot of spinach.
Spinach is funny because it does.
Yep.
It turns into nothing. So this is what you're talking about, how it pops. You know what? I can't believe you're only 26. You seem like you've been doing this for a long time.
Well, whatever you say in restaurants, you only have 10 years experience. It really means you have about 40 because you work 14 hours
every day. Yeah, exactly.
Not just 8 hours a day. I don't know. It was always something I enjoyed doing. Didn't really know what to do after high school, and this is what ended up working out for me really well. So
what do you like to cook when you're at home?
Whenever I'm at home, steak and potatoes.
You're a steak and potatoes guy. Good.
A lot of pasta. I don't eat too many vegetables.
Well, you stay very thin for being a pasta guy.
It's not that I don't try.
That's funny. How about some pizza? Good old pizza?
Yes. Of course, I go up to Gino's.
Yeah, of course. Of course you do. Where else would you go?
Mm-hmm.
So here we got the angel hair coming out, right?
Yep.
Put that in there.
Rather wrong one.
This is looking tasty. I always stand back at this point because I really don't want to get any oil on here or catch on fire or anything like that.
Once
that would
you get
be bad.
That warmed up. And the easiest
and that
thing about
pretty
this
simple.
Dish, yeah, the easiest thing about this dish
that.
Is everything. The hardest part is just making sure you don't burn the pine nuts and the garlic.
Unbelievable. Now what we're going to do after this, we're going to go back out in the kitchen. I'll talk to Gino again. And, oh, that smells fantastic. Or is that the bread cooking? I smell garlic.
Yep. That
smells
that
great.
Guy. Now, but the reason I always like to brown the pine nuts and the garlic is because you'll get all the flavor out of them. If they stay the same color, the white, they don't have any of that good flavor in the oils and the sugars that they produce.
So now what do you crumb? A little bit of feta?
Yep.
A little feta cheese?
Over top.
Nice.
And that kind of helps hold the pasta and the oil together.
Excellent. Well, we're going to try that then later. So what's the next thing we're making?
Next is the pork shank.
The pork shank,
yep.
which we didn't see that on film, but you threw this thing in there. Oh my goodness, look at that.
Yeah, they actually still get
held. Now that looks good.
They actually still get held in all the pork fat that I render down and confit them in.
Yeah.
So they can actually last a long time on the shelves. So, they fall off the bone. I keep them in the awesome of the fat because then it holds them together. If I try and take them out, they just fall apart.
Get out of here.
They're impossible to keep together.
And what's this dish called?
It's just our pork shank.
Pork shank.
Yep.
So now what are you going to do with this thing next?
After it goes into the oven, to warm it back up, right in the deep fryer. And it gets deep fried for about 2 to 3 minutes till the outside becomes crispy and it warms nice and middle.
Let me get this right. We started with this pork shank.
Yep.
You had fat all over
yes.
it when I saw it go in the oven.
Yep.
Right, confident, whatever. All over it.
Mm-hmm.
And now you bring it out. It's looked beautiful when it comes out.
Yeah.
And now you're deep frying this thing.
Yep.
What does that do? Then kind of just crisp it up on the outside.
It's already so loaded with oil at this point. They're just as you saw. Like I put it barely in there with any of the fat. And that's just what the fat that came out of it. So
wow.
The moisture and everything back in. Throw it in the oven. And it comes out.
This looks, I'm really, really excited to try this. Now, what do you serve this with?
This comes with potatoes, and it also comes with a scallion and bacon cream reduction.
Oh, man, that sounds good. Seriously, you're only 26.
Yeah.
Are you sure about this?
Uh-huh.
Did you ever go to formal schooling?
I went to Pennsylvania Cordon Bleu Institute in Pittsburgh. So
awesome.
I was there for a year and a half and got my degree from there. But
good for you, man.
Of that,
I'll tell you what.
Moved and worked and worked.
Learned,
on
right?
Every
you just
place,
pick up
yeah.
things. Every place you go, you learn something, right?
Yep.
I think
every
that's
kind
of the way cooking is, or kitchen, being a chef or anything. You know,
you learn
where you learn
it right.
on the job.
Yeah.
Yep. So now we're deep frying this thing. And this is a funny, now where did you get this idea from? That's the question.
This is actually from one of my first jobs. They did it with veal shanks. And
with veal shanks?
Yeah, and I liked it better with pork and kind of did it my own way. And I season them up different. And
well, it's also cheaper because veal shanks would be a little bit more expensive, I would think, right?
Wow, these are, this is, and also I just like taking lower cuts of meat and seeing what I can do with
them. Well, you do it, right, to make
those
it
are actually
good.
The more flavorful ones. So the ones you actually have to cook for longer and they just don't get cooked for 2 or 3 minutes.
Right, you're right. It's so true.
Because depending on these guys' size, they go anywhere from 16 to 24 hours in the oven overnight at 200 degrees. So they just sit there.
So it's a slow cook.
It's a very, very slow roast.
Like typical roast or pulled pork.
Yep.
I mean, that's what you do with pork when it's
even
like
my,
that.
My pulled pork, I do for 8 hours. My ribs, I do for 6.5, 7.
You do your pulled pork for 8 hours. That's not a whole lot of time, actually.
Yeah.
Sometimes people go a lot longer. Now, smoking it will go
smoking.
A lot longer, but not
a lot of restaurants will do them in like 3 or 4 hours, like in the oven, in a hot oven. Now, I slow roast mine at like 300 at a very low temp. Even keep the door cracked a little bit so it doesn't get too
awesome.
Hot in there and just let them go all day.
That's great. So now we got that done, and then you had talked about, we were talking about doing a some sort of an appetizer then too. So is that something we might be able to do, check out one of your appetizers?
Yeah, I don't see why not.
But you're going to plate this first, right?
Yeah.
And you plate that with the bone just like that.
Yep.
does it stick to the bottom?
Yeah, they're a little tricky to get off because you want to make sure you can get all the meat.
Yeah, you don't want to lose any meat. Look at that.
And that comes
look
out.
Look at that.
It's like that.
It looks like a big piece of bacon.
Yep.
Oh, man. Yeah. I can't wait to try that.
And all you pretty much have to do is touch it and everything just falls off the bone.
Yeah, it's like really... Oh, man. That's going to be good. All right, so are you going to do anything else with this or no? Just going to let that go?
No, I'll let you guys try that as is.
As is. All right, so we're going to move. We can move that over there with the pasta, and we'll try that later on. Now what about an appetizer? Can you do something for us?
Yeah, I think we'll do the loaded chips. That's nice and easy.
Oh, that sounds good. That sounds fun.
Yeah, let's do the potato skins. I like those better. They come out.
Oh, you know what's
nicer.
Funny? He just said potato skins. It's one of my favorites. Do you like potato skins? I love potato skins. Now, do you do? What are you going to put on your potato skins?
We do bacon, fresh shredded cheddar, tomato, and scallions.
Nice.
And then we pre-cook those slightly, and then we deep fry those to order, and then they come out all
nice. So you do your own potato skins?
Everything. The only thing that I don't make here is onion rings. And
why would you?
For right now, yeah.
Why would you?
That's really just right now. I think fingers and onion rings, everything else is made here.
Everything
sauces,
else is made.
Yeah. Everything's all fresh.
Good for
everything
you.
Comes in fresh.
That's awesome, yeah. Man. That's really cool. That's good.
I try not to freeze anything. Like a few of my bigger packs come in, but that's it.
Right, right, right. Now it looks like we got some other orders coming in here. It looks like a burger or something going out. Or
yep.
Does that sound right?
Yeah.
You guys do burgers.
Has,
you do
yep.
all kinds of stuff.
Burgers,
like that, right?
Sandwiches, pastas, big nice entrees. We'll be doing a separate lunch and dinner menu here shortly in a couple weeks.
Are you going to do a separate lunch menu?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Yeah, we are going to start that here in a couple weeks.
Now here's our potato skins. You know what's funny? So how do you make the potato skins? Oh, wait till he comes back. He's leaving me alone.
We actually take fresh russet potatoes.
Yep.
And we just core them out. We part bake them, and then we deep fry.
Do you use what's in the inside of that when you?
Yeah, I use that up for my mashed potatoes for some other filling, some special.
Right, because why waste it? Right, it's potato.
Exactly.
You know what's funny? I think you're the first show that has made potato skins in 2 years, 3 years. First show, and it's one of my favorite appetizers.
It's a nice, easy thing, but it's an easy
it
thing
is
to
easy,
even
but
screw
it's,
up.
It's also very good.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Cheese. Yummy. Notice pretty much everything was fried.
Yep.
Which is fine with me.
And actually, a lot of our food doesn't go into the deep fryer. The pork shank and this are
some of the only things.
It's actually our slow station, pretty much.
Well, that's good, though. That's good to hear. The grill gets a lot of work, I'm sure, right?
Our grill and the saute station is everything, yeah.
Yeah, wow. So then you put cheese on top of the bacon, too.
Yeah.
Wow. Amazing.
Sorry, we missed it a little bit.
Looks like it needs more. Well, you think it needs more bacon?
Yeah, we put a little bit more on top so you can do layers.
What do I look like? I need more bacon or what?
You're doing the hard work, so it's okay.
Thanks a lot, Gino.
You just want to give it layers. So
we're
going
to talk to you later.
All right.
But yeah, you want to have like different little bit of layers on there. You just don't want one layer of that.
Right.
This way you get a bite of everything and everything.
I like that.
And this goes over to our big
I like how
oven.
You think. Oh, we're traveling.
Yep. And I got bacon in there right now too, so.
Oh geez, look at this. You're making more bacon.
Yep.
How many pounds of bacon do you think you go through
In a week, I go through anywhere from 15 to 20.
That's not bad.
Oh.
For right now.
For right now,
yeah,
but
right
wait,
now,
right?
Only right now.
I bet you go through a lot at the breakfast place.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Yeah.
They probably go through 60 or 90 pounds.
Yep. Wow. That's incredible.
And even here, like, even all my bacon fat, like, I put that back into use. Like, I try not to throw anything away if I don't have to. The bacon fat goes back into the pork shank sometimes, or I use that for brews or saute into my soups.
You like to try to use everything that you can. Yeah,
especially
it's kind of sustainable.
Like, you're going to get more flavor, too, out of that.
Absolutely.
As opposed to just taking regular vegetable oil whenever you can saute with bacon fat.
Yeah, well, mine's funny. Like, I always tell the story about my mother-in-law. Mm-hmm. When she makes eggs in the morning, she fries up the bacon first. And then uses the bacon fat to fry up the eggs.
Yep.
And I'll tell you what, those eggs taste 10 times better than any other.
It's not exactly always the best for you, but it is.
No, it tastes good. That's right. Absolutely. You make your own chips then, too?
Yeah, we make our own chips. Pretty much just about everything here.
You know what
Every
I like?
Every day I run a chef's catch, normally a pasta special, a lunch special, so anything awesome. I can always keep going. We're starting to have different specials throughout the week.
Right.
We'll be having a pasta night, a prime rib night, everything like that. So awesome. All that's starting to come together as everybody's getting a little bit better.
What's your biggest seller right now? What are your biggest, most popular meal?
Honestly, our burgers are flying out. Our burgers
really?
And then right now a penne diablo that I do and aglio.
So the penne diablo is spicy, right?
Yeah. Got a kick
real spicy?
No, not real spicy.
Can you ask the chef to tone it down if I'd like?
Yeah.
Because my wife loves like a fra diablo type stuff, and I'm just not big on the spicy stuff. So sometimes it gets a little bit too much, but you can always say, hey, not so spicy.
Yep. No, I didn't. Okay. Pretty much all my dishes can always be toned down outside the buffalo sauce. So I think that's the only one they can.
So this is the potato skins, and then we're going to go out and try everything. And talk to Gino a little bit.
Got one more. Sorry about that.
Well, I'm going to say goodbye to you in the kitchen. I'm going to go out and try all this awesome food.
All right.
And I want to say thanks so much, man. You're doing
Thank
a great
you very
job.
Much.
I would never know that you're 26.
Thanks.
You got 20. You're 20 years younger than me. Let's put it that way.
I feel old. I turned 27 in 2 months.
You're not old. You're doing well. You're doing well. But you got some great stuff going here. I'm
Thank
really
you
excited
very
to come back to the restaurant to try more of your dinners and specials and things. So congratulations and good luck. All right.
Thank you. Thank
all
you
right,
for coming
care.
In today.
You're welcome. So we're sitting here with Gino, the man of the hour. I want to thank you for having us out here. And I also want to say your chef, for his age, is way beyond his years.
Yeah, he's a good guy. He's a really hardworking. And I just give him a chance. And he's like, thank you so much for making me do that. I was, you know, when I started up doing my own thing, I was 25.
Oh, no way.
So I know the feeling
old.
Somebody who loved to open a,
his
own kitchen and stuff like that. So I give it this opportunity to this guy, so.
That's awesome. Great.
Really
good for
happy.
You. Good for you.
I'm
and
really
you have,
happy.
You must be going crazy, too.
I'm all over the place.
You have Gino's Cafe, which we've done a show at.
Yep.
Gino's Cafe. You have now the Gino's Grille here.
Yep.
But before this, you opened, you Blue took
Marsh.
Over Blue Marsh Canteen.
Italian. No, Blue Marsh,
Blue Marsh Italian.
It used to be Blue Marsh Canteen. Now it's Blue Marsh Italian Restaurant.
Gotcha. But that's yours also.
Yeah.
Which I heard is doing very well.
Really amazing.
That's
amazing.
Awesome. That's really cool. Well, so, yeah, I'm just amazed. Except when I saw that you were doing this restaurant, I was sitting here thinking, my gosh, how much more can this guy do?
I mean, if you have a good people work for you and everything else, like I say, I have my brother, my sister, they're partners with me at the other shop at Blue Marsh. So I have my brother cooking out there. So people you can trust.
Okay, good.
And now, like I say, we have this guy here. He put a lot of time in there. If anybody call off, he's always available. It's somebody
Amazing.
Who really wants to work.
That's great.
That's what
good.
We need in this country.
You got that right. And you know what? It's good to see a young man like himself that's actually very dedicated to it.
Yep.
And he made some amazing food, which I'm going to be trying.
There you
go. Just wanted to say thank you.
You're welcome.
And I think it's great what you're doing. We were out here with my family, and I love the look of the restaurant, too.
Thank
it's
you.
A totally different look. So if you think that this is the same, if I'm talking to people out there, if you think it's the same as it was before, it's not. And there's also a bar coming.
Bar coming. We're going to get a liquor license, so we're going to get approval from the township. So hopefully there up front, we're going to build
awesome.
A bar there. Yeah.
Great. Sounds good. Well, I'm going to try some of your food and,
Thank
and
you so much.
Let the people know what's going on
I really appreciate
here.
For coming in.
You're very
and
welcome.
And I'll see you next time at Blue
Yes,
Marsh.
Exactly.
All right, thank
to go
you.
There.
Enjoy,
All right.
okay?
All right.
Anything
thank
you need,
you.
Let me know.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
All right. So here we are. I'm going to try some of this food. I am missing my cohort, Mickey Baines, but he's been doing some shows without me. I'm doing shows without him. It's kind of the way it works when you're busy people. But the first thing I'm going to try, actually, is the potato skin, just because it's a starter. It's an appetizer, so why not start right here? And this is actually one of my favorite appetizers. And I'm going to take this and dip it in some sour cream. And it's going to stay in the sour cream. How do you like that? There's nothing like a potato skin. It's so simple, yet so good. A lot of bacon. A lot of cheese. Very, very good. Joan, you're going to love this one. When we're done filming, you're going to love these. These are really good. All right, so that's that. Put this back. That's really good. What's nice about what I was talking to the chef about was he doesn't make, these are not frozen. He actually bakes the potato, scrapes it out, uses the inside of the potato for, you know, mashed potatoes or whatever, and then uses these then for potato skins. So it's just nice to have something that's not frozen, you know. And he said he already freezes anything. So the next thing I'm really, really, really interested in trying was this pork shank confit. And he said it should just, oh my gosh, are you seeing this? Like, I barely put my fork on there. Now, this was put in pork fat. It sat in there, cooked for, in the oven for, like, overnight. And then he takes it and he deep fries it after that, which I think is kind of funny because there's a lot of frying going on and a lot of fat, but this should taste amazing. Oh, my God. Really? Oh, my gosh. I'm going to have to ask Zach, where has this been all my life? That is by far probably the best pork I've ever tasted in my life. Oh, man. You know what it tastes like on the outside? It tastes like fried chicken on the outside and then pulled pork on the inside. That's fantastic. Oh, my gosh. I'm going to need to eat more of that. Mickey, you are missing out, man. I'll tell you what. This is a show you should have been on. I think he's in North Carolina somewhere, actually, which is kind of funny. So this is the aggiola or whatever. I forget how he said it, but we're just going to go with that. Basically a Greek pasta. Ooh, this is tough to get out of here. A Greek pasta that has, like, tomatoes and feta cheese and has a little chicken on top here. Very garlicky. I can smell that. Has the pine nuts in here, some tomato. So we're just going to kind of cut this up a little bit. Broil a little bit. Oh, wow. Fantastic. Oh, my gosh, that is good. Mickey, you are missing out. Oh, my gosh. That is good. Really good. I just got to try the chicken yet. Mmm, it's so good. It's amazing. And there's, like, look at the feta cheese on there. Man, this food is incredible. Really incredible. Well, I'll tell you what. I gotta get out of here because it's time for me to end the show. So just want to say thank you again for watching Best Bites on bctv.org. And the food here at Gino's Grill is amazing. I definitely suggest you come out here. It's on Lancaster Avenue. Near Gallon Insurance, and it's just an amazing place to come. So come out here, support this great restaurant, and we'll see you next month.
Best Bites on BCTV is supported by Comfort Pro Incorporated.
While the holidays should be a time of joy, there are many potential fire hazards that could ruin them.